And mind the blood.
He's basically trying to take over all the gangs in Gotham City.
I love stories that where Batman really is put through it emotionally, where it's not just he has to fight somebody.
We get to see that man have insecurities, have concerns about, am I doing the right thing?
Really, we're dealing more with mortal men. These are not superpowered heroes that can take huge punches and survive, or you know, shoot laser beams out of their eyes. This is a story of men.
Batman's struggle is very deep because he's confronted very seriously with his actions, with the results of his actions.
The stakes feel higher, death feels closer.
The emotional core of the story is really, really strong, and I don't want to say deep, but yeah, kind of deep.
This is more about a man pushed to his limits by his greatest enemies, and he's hell-bent on solving a mystery that affects the very core of who he is.
I had never seen anything so dark as where this story started, where it went through, and how it was going to end.
Situations that are really life and death, and it has elements of a horror story, elements of a thriller.
The themes are dark. The themes are heavy.
Looking at this piece, I was more reminded of Batman the Animated Series as far as how dark it was.
In my book, Bruce Timm invented really the ultimate Gotham City when he did Batman the Animated Series. And that's a series that I grew up watching, and it's largely the reason why I'm working in animation today.
But we did everything within our power to make sure that it didn't exactly look like Batman the Animated Series, because, you know, we just didn't want to do that again.
I think film noir affected our color choices, our filmmaking. So this is a much darker movie than the usual DC animated movie, as it should be.
A lot of this looks like from Doug Monkey's hand, who was our primary artist on this. It won't look like other Batman features that you've seen before.
Gotham and Batman, they both lend themselves to a darker color palette and just darker images in general.
We've assembled a really, really awesome cast to play these parts, and the script being what it is, has a lot of really juicy meat for an actor to sink his teeth into.
You want to dance? Let's dance.
We needed to get an actor who could portray better times and the worst of times.
Jensen Ackles is a really dynamite performer from TV, obviously from TV's Supernatural.
Listen to me, you drug-peddling scumbags. You eight are the most prosperous street dealers in Gotham. I'm offering you morons a deal.
It's interesting to me, I think, whenever you're listening to a dramatic scene, to hear an actor fight against the emotion they're feeling.
You want to rule them by fear, but what do you do with the ones who aren't afraid? I'm doing what you won't. I'm taking them out.
His instincts are really good in animation.
I figured I'd just come in here and ask questions about what I didn't know and pretend like I knew something and hope to get away with it.
We were so very lucky to get Bruce Greenwood. I've been a fan of his for a very long time.
Bruce Greenwood was always my first choice to play Bruce Wayne in this movie, to play Batman.
Lie to me again, and crashing into a wall head-on will be the least painful activity of your evening.
He brings this real gravitas to every performance that he does. He's just really, really solid and really grounded. And at some point when I was watching some movie that he was in, I was listening to his voice and thought, wow, you know, it's like, that guy, he could be Batman. It's like, he's got that awesome voice.
I had to take him down.
You shattered his collarbone.
He's a drug-dealing pimp. I didn't think I had to prop up some pillows before I took him out.
We needed him. He would have talked, but you put him into shock.
We just toyed around with different timbers for 20 minutes or so. We read the script the whole way through when we were looking for the tone of the voice, and by the time we'd sort of finished the first read-through, we're kind of going, okay, it's a little, you know, it's a little bit, it's got a little bit of smoke in it, but not too much.
I'm chatty. It's part of my charm.
Neil Patrick Harris is somebody that we've worked with many times in the past. He's super, super talented, sweet guy, perfect guy.
You can't turn on TV without seeing him on something. And he came in to play Nightwing for me.
Could you just once say, let's get in the car? Is that so hard?
He's youthful, and he's kind of like the yin to Batman's yang. You know, he's a serious, driven superhero, but he's also, you know, not as dark and broody as Batman. So he's a good foil for all of Batman's darkness.
It's so intense. It's an intense, intense piece.
You're taking what was already a high octane DC story and just supercharging it.
We've made ourselves an opera. That is a dark story. It's a psychological story. Things that you saw in Christopher Nolan's Dark Knight, things that you've seen in Frank Miller's Dark Knight Returns, they're here. We're seeing Batman as we've never seen him before.
What's fun about this movie is that in addition to dealing with, you know, Batman's past and how it comes to confront him, it's still also a detective story. There's a mystery at the heart of this. And I think all of the best Batman stories ultimately are mysteries.
All I've ever wanted to do is kill him. A day doesn't go by when I don't think about subjecting him to every horrendous torture he's dealt out to others, and then end him.